One of the great things about being a sculptor is that you get to spend all day with your imagination, which I think is a lot of fun. These are some of my favorite pieces that I've been working on over the years. They're made from staplers, old badges, old camera parts, engine parts, whatever inspires me to make something. It's almost like these things kind of find me as much as I would like to think that I found them. When I was a kid, my mom used to drag me to antique stores on Saturday mornings. And so while she was looking at porcelain plates and furniture, I was always attracted to this brass pieces of metal over in some corner that was some instrument that who knows what it did. And I think from there, I was just always looking at those things, always kind of interested in history and objects that were mechanical. Walt is like the first piece that I ever built. And I named him after Walt Disney. I found the head first, it's from the 1920s. And then I just kind of built everything from that era. So I really like that piece. And then this is Scout. And he's made out of all these wonderful old pieces of tin that are all hammered on. It takes forever to do. But the end result is really nice, so that's why I do it. But this spider is made from old piano, parts of a piano, I think the keys. And then the body is made from an old desktop fan. I mean, I use chopsticks here on the end, but I made these little cars from old cameras for a show. Everything had to be small, and I wanted them to look like toys from the 30s. First, I spend a lot of time finding the parts. And then because it's a robot, there's symmetry. You know, he's got two arms, he's got two legs, he's got a head. So you have to kind of look for, I kind of changed my perception of how I'm looking for things, and what you might consider something strange, I would say that's a head, or you know, that's a chest, or maybe those are shoulders. All these materials are antiques, so you have to learn a little bit about metal, you have to learn about leather, you have to learn about polishing metal, cutting metal, wood, woodworking, and so you have to learn all those different things, which becomes kind of challenging, and bringing these staplers, fans, and radio parts to life, where you don't even see that. You see this creature first, and then you start to look in close and go, oh wow, that's a knob, that's a screw. I think that for myself, it adds to the believability of looking at the thing that it's alive if you can't see any bolts or screws. So I try to hide all mine, unless it was already there, and then I kind of use it to my advantage. There are people that come in that are retired scientists, retired engineers, workers, and they can recognize parts of some of these pieces. Some people don't know what any of these parts are, and then the person next to them goes, oh, it's a drive-in speaker. And they go, what is that? You know, it's really fun to introduce people to things that they have grown up with and have forgotten about. And then there are other people that get to see something new that they knew nothing about. There's something about this golden age of being a child, maybe it's between the ages of like 7 and 11, where you can see it in their eyes when they go to a movie and they're actually believing what's happening on the screen. And I think that I was attracted to creating something like that, that was lighthearted, that would make people smile, that wouldn't scare kids, and that was just of a time when we're innocent and we're happy.